Hello, viewer. Welcome to today's episode of Women's View. Today is our special edition, and we're going to be in the kitchen, and we're going to be making something that is very easy to make, very delicious, and I really want you to try this at home. So I want to give you a few tips on how to make it easier for you. First of all, we are going to be live on Facebook, so you can watch us on Facebook. The handle is GBS Kenya, and then we're going to put up the link on YouTube. The channel is GBS TV Kenya, and after the show is over, we're actually going to write down the recipe for you, put it on our blog, on our website, and all this is just to help you to be able to repeat this delicious cake at home. So I have with me in studio a very lovely lady. She's a chef, and she's going to show us how to make this very interesting cake. I want her to introduce herself, and then we can get on with the program. All right, welcome.
Thank you. Hello guys, I'm Chef Lynette, and I'm here to share all the ideas I have all about bakery, and it's something simple, something fun to do, and something, what I'm going to make today, it's something that you can make at home, and it's interesting.
It's interesting and it's simple. Yeah. So what is the title, what kind of a cake are we making today?
It's sort of like, let me say, it's like a Kenyan cuisine. It's called a masala cake.
Oh, it's a masala cake.
Yeah, people hardly make it, but
yes,
yeah, it's nice, simple.
And you know, Kenyans love their tea,
yeah,
and they love their masala tea.
Yeah.
So if you can have masala in, yeah, your tea and also masala in your cake, yeah, I think if you're a masala kind of person, you're gonna your day will be made. Yeah.
And also the guys who love spices too.
Ah, yeah, yes, that's true.
Something for them to.
The cake is not flat. It's full of flavor,
yeah,
and full of spices.
Yeah.
Actually, I've never thought that you can use masala,
mm-hmm,
in cake. This, yeah, is a first for me, so
okay,
I'm sure my viewer is also very excited and interesting to follow.
Okay.
So how are we going to do what we're going to do? Take us through the ingredients, and then we see whether they're easily available or whether it's complicated to find.
Here we have some whipping cream,
mm-hmm,
of which we're going to whip so that we can thicken it.
Okay.
Here we have some icing sugar.
Yes.
We have some flour with some baking powder.
Okay.
We have some butter.
Yes.
Some mixed spices,
mm-hmm,
which comprise of nutmeg,
mm-hmm,
black pepper, cinnamon, and cardamom.
Okay.
And we have some eggs over here.
Ah, excellent. Yeah. Very simple.
Actually, it's so simple.
And I noticed that instead of using normal sugar,
yeah,
you're using icing sugar.
Yeah, you can use normal sugar, but I prefer using icing sugar because it's fast to dissolve.
Ah,
to mix,
okay,
with the butter.
Yes.
Yeah.
Cool. Fine. So those are the ingredients. So I think we can start.
Okay. So.
All right. As you put the ingredients, you can tell us the quantities, because
we're
making a cake. What size?
We are making like 1.5 kg. Cake.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Here we have icing sugar.
Yes.
Of which you're going to add over here.
Okay. How much of icing sugar are you using?
I'm using 250. Grams of icing
grams.
Sugar.
Okay.
Yes.
A quarter kg.
Yeah, a quarter kg.
Mm. And it's so amazing the way icing sugar is usually so white. Eh?
Yeah, so white.
White. Because now when you put it next to the flour,
yeah,
you can actually see the difference.
Yeah.
All right. So there is the icing sugar into the bowl.
This can get a little bit messy.
I know. Actually, the thing with the baking is that the flour usually goes everywhere.
Everywhere.
It's always so advisable to have an apron.
But
because, you know, by the time you're done, you just white everywhere. And that's part of the fun, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
So
the butter and the icing sugar are in the bowl.
Yeah. Let me mix it.
Mix
so
it
that
a
can
little.
Be easy for me to use the mixer.
Okay. You have a spatula.
Yeah.
I have
a spatula. Yeah. It's very important.
Uh-huh. This is much better than Mikos.
Yeah, Mikos. So that it will help you to reduce wastage.
And to reduce, you know, when you start beating, the flour, the icing sugar tends to just go into the air a lot.
Exactly.
So it's like you're trying to mix a bit of it in there.
Yeah.
Mm. Of course, in the event that you don't have butter, would it be, because butter is expensive,
it's quite expensive,
but it adds that extra flavor to the cake.
Yeah, making the cake is sort of unique.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
But if you don't have, or it's a bit on the higher side, you can use butter or margarine?
Margarine, you can
Blueband.
Use it, yeah.
Or okay.
Prestige, any can
prestige,
do.
Or Prestige, any can do. But the recommended one is butter.
Yeah.
How much butter did you put?
I used 250 grams. Mm-hmm. It's 1:1 ratio.
1:1 for everything.
Yeah, even the flour.
That's easy. That's so easy to remember.
Yeah.
The same amount of icing sugar.
Yeah.
The same amount of flour. The same amount of butter.
Yeah.
All right. Cool.
So
So let me step back because I do not want
whiteness. It's not going to be messy.
Whiteness on my hair and on my all my clothes.
Yeah.
It's not so bad.
It's not messy. As long as you don't lift your whisk. Mix up.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Does it matter the direction you go? Can you go in front,
no,
back?
Any can
there's
do.
There's no formula?
Yeah, there's no formula.
Okay.
Yeah.
The important thing is that they mix.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can also use a whisk, but I prefer this because it is faster.
It's faster.
Yes, you're going to save some energy.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The electric mixer.
Yeah.
But if you don't have it, you can use a whisk.
Yeah, you can use a whisk.
And before we had whisks, actually, when I was growing up and we were baking with my mom, we used to use a miko.
Miko, yeah.
And actually, you beat the sugar and the blue band until it's white.
Yeah.
And it should be so exhausting.
It's even becoming white,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's what we're going for. That's the color that the consistency and the color that we're going for.
Okay,
nice.
We're going to add some eggs.
Some eggs,
or
right.
one by one,
yeah. Not all together,
not all together. Until it curdles.
Mm.
Yeah,
you have to go step by step.
Yeah, step by step.
Yeah, you'd have to take your time. Huh?
Yeah.
Mm. The first egg is in.
Yeah.
Now, you know, nowadays there are lots of people who have allergies.
Yeah.
If you don't do eggs,
yeah, there are
what is
eggless.
An alternative?
They're eggless cakes.
They're eggless cakes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But for this particular cake, can you make it without the eggs?
Yeah, you can make it without
the
eggs.
What would you then put at this point instead of the eggs?
We will just put all the other ingredients except for the eggs on.
And that would not make the cake significantly different.
Okay, the smell will be different, the taste will be different, and it won't rise compared to the ones that have the eggs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. So eggs have a role they play.
Yeah, yeah.
And honestly, most people love eggs.
Yeah, eggs.
So if you're not on eggs, you can avoid them. But you know, they have a flavor they add and.
Yeah.
They help the cake to rise.
Yeah.
And I like the way you're so easy. You just hit the egg on the side, you know. Not much drama about. Yeah. Get me a bowl, get me a fork.
No.
So basically, if you discovered pastry and baking after you went to school, it means that when you were going to your catering school, you had something else in mind.
Yeah.
What were you going to for?
Actually, I was thinking to be a nurse.
Oh, you wanted to be a nurse?
Yeah.
Wow, what a diversion.
No. But...
Are you nursing people with food? Good food?
Yeah, right now it's nursing people with good food. But I discovered that it's good to do something that you're good at.
Yes.
And I discovered that I was good at in the kitchen.
Okay.
And
okay.
It's something that I love.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You went with your passion.
Yeah, my passion.
Yeah. Right. That's okay. I mean, I think that's always the if you're able to align your passion with your work.
Okay.
Why are you putting two at the same time?
Okay. No, it's okay. At the end, you can put.
At the end, you can put two. Yeah. Oh, okay. Here I am trying to correct
good.
The chef.
It's good.
Really,
it's good. It's good.
You know, it's just good. That's what you told me. Yeah. So I'm wondering. Okay, have the rules changed?
I'm seeing that we are together.
We are together. Here.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So at the end, it's okay. You can put two eggs in.
Until it starts to curdle.
Yes, I'm seeing that the consistency is changing. Actually, this is what you call curdling.
Yeah.
Curdling is like a bit like the way milk starts to go off.
Yeah.
Sort of.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then why does that happen? Because of the beating.
Yeah.
Okay.
And after that. This is what this tells you, that it's time to put the flour now.
When you get to this stage.
Yeah.
So before you get here, it means you need to keep adding eggs.
Yeah.
Remember, this is 250 grams of flour. Wheat flour.
Yeah, and some baking powder.
How much?
Be like one teaspoon.
One teaspoon. Yeah.
And not a full like. Whole teaspoon, like you have to
a level.
Measure.
Mm. Or you use a measuring spoon to get the exact quantity.
Yeah.
Because if you, what is the problem of putting too much baking powder?
Sometimes you might find that it hasn't risen.
Because of too much?
Yeah, too much. At the same time, it can rise, but the way after you've baked it, the way it's going to appear.
Yeah. Too airy.
Too airy.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Because what baking powder does is it makes it rise.
Yeah.
So you don't want it to over-rise.
Yeah, this is called folding in.
Yeah, that's called folding in. So at this point, you don't use your bitter.
You don't have to use the bitter.
Yeah. You can fold it in.
So that you can be able to mix everything over here.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Nice. There we go. So you just use a spatula. The spatula is good because it's able to get everything from the side.
Yeah. It's something interesting to do.
Yeah.
But you will find yourself that you're not having it.
Yeah,
it's if I have guests in my place, I'll be so happy to help them to make for them some cake.
Yeah.
And I will find myself not having it at all. And they'll ask me, why don't you have it?
I know.
I'm like, I've been doing these things for long.
All my life. Yeah. I'm not impressed the way you guys are impressed.
Yeah.
So I see that you've added in the spices. And how much of spice should you put?
This depends on how much spice you love.
Okay.
It's just like when you're cooking.
It's like when you put in salt.
Yeah, but don't put too much.
Don't put too much, Nutmeg tends to smell very nice.
Yeah, it can smell.
So this is tea masala?
Yeah, tea masala. You can use tea masala or a mixture of spices, that's nutmeg, cardamom, cinnamon, and black pepper too.
Okay.
Black pepper.
Imagine up to this point, you've not added any water, milk.
You don't have to add any water.
And who thought that you can?
You can.
But it's not necessary.
It's not necessary.
Because the consistency is good, you know?
Yeah.
Sometimes people feel they want to add water and milk because it's like not soft enough.
Yeah.
But it's not a must.
You don't have to.
Yeah. Your eggs are able to give give it the enough liquid it
needs. And the butter too.
And the butter. The butter is also moist.
Yeah.
Okay.
We are done.
Can you imagine? I mean, in such a short time, it's over.
Yeah.
Okay, this part. Of course, there's the oven part, yeah?
Yeah.
I need to remind my viewers that before we started the show, we had already switched on our oven, because whenever you're baking, you do have to preheat the oven.
Yeah, we have to.
By the way, just explain to me, why is that so? Why can't you just put it into an oven and then switch on the oven? Why must you preheat the oven?
It's important so that you'll use less time.
Okay.
Because it's like when you prepare some rice.
Yes.
You have to boil the water.
Before.
Yeah,
okay.
Before. Mm-hmm. You'll use less time.
Okay.
And the temperature, you have to make the temperature to be even all over.
Mm. Yeah. Okay, I get it. Cool. So what next?
We are going to scoop it to the baking
tin. To the baking tin, This is usually a very tricky stage, the baking tin.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you can bake a cake, it gets ready, and then when you remove it from the oven and you turn it upside down, it refuses to get out of the baking tin.
Yeah.
How annoying. And then now you have to start. You know, those ukarabatis.
Yeah.
So tell us, what have you done to this baking tin to make that not happen?
Here I've used a greaseproof paper.
Okay.
Yeah. And before I used it, I had to apply some buttercream.
Okay.
And stick the greaseproof paper and a bit of some buttercream.
Yes.
And some icing sugar.
Ah.
Simple.
So that the bottom of it will actually...
Easy for you.
Ah, okay. Yeah. So the baking tin has got some buttercream.
Yeah.
Then you put the grease paper.
Yeah.
And then at the bottom of the grease paper, I can see that you've sprinkled some icing sugar.
Yeah.
So that the bottom of the cake will have a little of those white things, huh?
Basically, no.
Not really?
Yeah,
okay.
It's like to prevent it also from sticking. And
yeah.
Easy for you to remove it when you're
Oh, to remove the paper, the grease paper.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah. Cool. Okay. It's not pouring because it's not liquid enough.
Yeah.
You're transferring.
Yeah, it's thick.
Yeah, it's quite thick. Yeah. So you put it onto your baking tin. You can, of course, have the very many shapes of baking tins, yeah?
Yeah, you can also use cupcakes.
You can use cupcakes, yeah?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The spatula helps a lot because it helps to scoop
and reduce wastage.
Yeah,
too.
It cleans the sides very well. And based on your experience, of course, mm-hmm. a lot of people sometimes want to taste this mm-hmm. to make sure that the sugar is enough.
It's okay, yeah.
But you know, mm-hmm. at this point, can you really add anything? If you taste it and you find it doesn't have enough sugar, can you add?
As long as you've not removed it from the oven, mm-hmm. you can like take it mm-hmm. back and mix, add the sugar.
Oh, you can.
But huh? I prefer to be on the safe side.
Yeah.
Just make sure you've measured all your ingredients.
Right.
Actually, when it comes to pastry, mm-hmm. it's important when it comes to measuring your ingredients.
Exactly. Yeah.
And not to mess up everything.
Yes.
Because you can do a lot of work, mm-hmm. and then at the end you get your product is...
It's off. The yeah. taste is not the one that you had in
yeah.
mind.
Yeah.
And then that's a disappointment.
Then
you know?
You know you have to throw it away, which is a loss.
It's a loss. Yeah. I'll start thinking of adding things on top, yeah. like syrups and all that. Yeah. Okay. Okay. All right, there we have it. Our cake yeah. is looking lovely. Mm-hmm. Okay, not yet cake. Yeah. Our what do you call this?
This masala cake.
Masala cake.
Yeah.
The mix the mix
the butter,
is
the butter
with an A.
Yeah, butter with an A.
Butter is ready.
Yeah.
So now
the way it looks like it's going to, when it goes to the oven, mm-hmm. it's going to actually
it's going to settle.
Yeah.
Oh, so you don't have to be so particular about making it smooth.
You don't have to.
Okay. All right. Cool.
And you have to be watchful.
Yes.
When you're done with your cake, don't go anywhere. Just keep your
be
eyes
around.
On the cake.
Yeah, don't at the start drying and going to visit the neighbors.
It will be okay.
And then it burns.
Yeah.
Be nearby to keep looking at it. Keep an eye on the cake, Well, she's really simplified it. Mm. And basically, we put the cake into the oven. And then we put, what's the temperature?
150
degrees. For how long?
For 40 to 45 minutes.
40 to 45 minutes. Yeah. And one thing you mentioned is that it's not a good idea to open the oven.
You shouldn't open the oven at all. Don't even think about it. Because
sometimes
you can be tempted to open so that you can see how it's going.
I know.
But you shouldn't open it because once you open it, mm-hmm. The temperature that was inside the oven is definitely going to change because you're going to add less.
To add in cold air.
Cold air.
Ah, okay.
And then at the end, the cake ends up sinking.
The cake will flop.
Flop,
so after 45 minutes are over, you do still need to check to confirm that the cake is ready.
Yeah.
And how do you test?
You can use a knife.
Okay, use a knife.
Actually, we've cut the top layer.
Yeah, we've cut the top layer because we wanted this this look.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you just have to...
You put the knife inside.
Yeah, and then... Once it comes out clean, the cake is
when
ready.
It comes out clean, yes. If it's sticky, it means it's not ready. If it's not ready, you put it back in.
Fast as possible.
As fast as possible,
mm-hmm.
But if you've done everything right, the correct temperature, the correct time, most of the time it tends to be ready.
Yeah.
And then you just put, you remove the baking tin, upside down it onto your surface.
And let it cool.
Clean.
First, you have to make sure it's cool.
It's cold,
cold.
So you should have refrigerated before?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you measure or you just
guess? You can...
You can use your eyes.
Yeah, you can use just your
eyes. It's basically a milk product.
Yeah, it is. Mm.
Yeah. All right. So you put it into the mixer.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm. And then you beat it, huh?
Yeah, you beat it.
Okay.
This is like adding air.
You add air into it.
Yeah, so that can...
You can flatten up, but you bake at home.
Mm-hmm.
It's because the whole home mm-hmm. tends to get the smell of what you're baking.
Exactly.
And so when your children come home, when your friends come home, when you come home, mm-hmm. you're just like, already it's like an appetizer.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's how you tell that your whipped cream is ready. You do have to have the right ingredients because they generally tend to just make your work easier.
Yeah.
You know, the palette knife is it's more preferred. But, you know, if you don't have one, you can always use...
You can use a knife.
You can use a knife, you can use a spoon, whatever you have in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Because I don't want my viewer to feel like I'm not going to bake until I buy a turntable.
You don't have to.
I'm not going to bake until I buy a palette
before
knife.
Before I bought it, before I had it, I used to use a sphoria.
Mm.
And plate. I place a plate on top and the cake.
Oh, and then you turn the soufflé.
Yeah, simple.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Clever girl.
Yeah.
You can always come. You know, whatever excuse that you have, yeah, you can always find a way of, you know, going around it.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go.
Okay, we can add some fruits on top too.
Yes.
But for now, we don't have
for them. Now, we're just making it simple. It's a masala cake.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, my dear. Thank you so much for keeping it here. And basically, we want you to try this at home. Remember that the recipe is going to be on our blog. If you go to gpskenya.com and you go to the blog, the category is Let's Cook. You're going to find the written recipe. And then it's going to be possible for you to do this at home. Please give us a parting shot before we wrap up the show.
Yeah. For me, I would say that it's, if you love something, go ahead for it. Go for it. And don't do something because you want to make someone happy. Do something because you love it. Yes.
Excellent. Yeah. Just like you. Yeah. You're basically a pastry chef because that's what you love.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Give us your contacts as well so that in case somebody wants to reach out to you, they can be able to.
It's 07-0183-0072. Or you can find me on Instagram, mianolinette. Or on my email, linettemiano@gmail.com.
All right. Please reach out to her and she can be able to make a cake for you, whether it's your birthday, whether it's something you're celebrating, or she can even come to your home to help you to be able to bake at home. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining us today, and we look forward to seeing you next time.